On the eve of the 49th annual March for Life, Joe Biden's Department of Health and Human Services launched an extreme pro-abortion task force, the so-called Task Force on Reproductive Health Care Access. Not only did they announce this initiative, but they also funneled an additional $6.6 million to the Title X Family Planning Program. Under the current administration, important rules have been removed that used to limit abortions from being covered through Title X. The new task force, aimed at expanding abortion access in all 50 states, outlines its intention to remove policies that stand in the way of the abortion industry. Meanwhile, nearly $2 million in Title X grant money is going to Planned Parenthood, the nation's largest abortion business. HHS has confirmed that this initiative is in response to Texas's heartbeat law. Seven states, including Texas, will now receive federal funding to cover abortion on demand, whether they want it or not. HHS Secretary Javier Becerra says he is committed to strengthening and protecting access to abortion. Joining us now is Loretta Brown, reporter for our sister publication, the National Catholic Register. Thanks for joining us, Loretta.
Thanks for having me.
Let's dive right in. HHS has taken several actions under the Biden administration to promote abortion on demand. Given that, is this new task force really surprising to you, especially given that it was introduced on the eve of the anniversary of Roe versus Wade?
Sadly, Prudence, this task force really didn't surprise me. I've seen, you know, the Biden-Harris administration growing more and more pro-abortion over the past year.
Right.
And really what I think caused that is the possibility that the Supreme Court could overturn Roe versus Wade with this Dobbs case. And so they've been facing pressure from the abortion industry to really come out with an intense pro-abortion stance. And one example of that is their backing of the Women's Health Protection Act, which is a very extreme piece of legislation that would essentially bar the states from limiting abortion, you know, stop pro-life laws in the states. And so while that doesn't look like it would pass Congress, their backing of that, I think, just shows they've really embraced this pro-abortion stance, and now with this task force especially.
Mm. And HHS has also awarded $6.6 million to the Title X program, and this money will now go towards pro-abortion businesses. Can you explain this program? Is it ethical, Loretta?
So the Title X Family Planning Program is supposed to go to comprehensive family planning methods and testing and counseling, and there are life-affirming resources and centers, and the Biden administration here has decided to give millions to Planned Parenthood. And Planned Parenthood, their main business is abortion. You know, the president of Planned Parenthood talks about that. If you look at their annual reports, it's the main part of what they do. It is who they are. Mm-hmm. And so I think it is very concerning to pro-life taxpayers to see so much money going to such a pro-abortion organization, an abortion provider. And, you know, money, when it's given to an organization, to one part of it, it really frees up funds in other parts of the organization. So it really is concerning to see this abortion organization receiving funding from the government like this.
Yes, and can you explain the differences between what the Title X program looked like under the Trump administration and now under the Biden administration? I'm pretty sure that during the Trump administration, abortions were not allowed to be covered in Title X.
That's right, Prudence. So under the Trump administration, there was the Protect Life Rule, which very clearly said, you know, abortion providers, so organizations that refer for abortions, mm-hmm. or that are physically located in the same place where abortions are provided, cannot get this Title X money. And what that did was show just a clear, distinct line of separation between Title X family planning funds, which are not meant to go to abortion, not meant to go directly there, and abortion organizations, right? So that there's no ambiguity there. And now the Biden administration has just removed that rule, and there's just such a lack of clarity, and there's cause for concern.
Indeed. And just looking ahead, what are you hearing we should be keeping our eye on, aside from this, when it comes to the Biden-Harris administration?
So one of the things I'm monitoring especially are executive orders and guidance from the administration on the abortion issue, because right now, as I mentioned, the Women's Health Protection Act, so in Congress, they're not seeing legislation like that going through. And they're also concerned about the Supreme Court overturning Roe. So they don't have the avenue of, you know, pushing some extreme abortion legislation through Congress. So I think they're going to increasingly try to act you know, through executive order, through guidances issued. Recently, the Biden administration, FDA, removed the in-person dispensing requirement for the abortion pill mifepristone, which can be very risky for women.
Right.
So many pro-life advocates spoke out about that, and I think pro-life advocates just need to watch these actions and continue to speak out, because unfortunately, I think we're going to see a lot more of them.
Loretta, we're thankful for your solid reporting on this. Loretta Brown of the National Catholic Register, thanks for joining us.
Thanks, Prudence.